streamers are getting great views. I just so you know, the Disney news show. I put it down like you kept saying unpresidential. And
well, no, I think like I've had some really interesting conversations with some relatives of mine. Some of them in my own age bracket or a little younger, and some of them older. And you know, I'm having one of those moments.
Can we
where,
look
yes,
at the movie?
Most of the last 20 years of my life in beach towns or in New York City or San Francisco, where things are a little looser, right? And so there's been some interesting conversations. Because I remember people reacting to Bill Clinton playing sax on, oh my goodness, the Arsenio Hall show. And people being like, he just kissed it. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, the idea of what the president, you know, can do has certainly broadened. And Obama has managed to embrace it. And certainly through the way he embraces technology, he has always been very presidential about it. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not looking at my, you know. I'm not getting like 32 tweets in 22 minutes and finding out that Obama had cutlets at lunch. You know,
I think he's kind of signaled already. The last post was November 4th, election day, and it said get out the vote. I think once he got elected, stop using Twitter. I think he's already said, in effect, by his use, we're going to go to change.gov. They set up that site. This is, you know, follow the transition online. He's got a blog. He's got a newsroom. He's got an agenda. They were at, you know, they changed it around a little. Share your ideas. I think it's important that the government embrace transparency and embrace technology to do it. And I just think we're only arguing about the best way.
Yeah, I guess my question is I think a lot of the ways. Like, I mean, you know, Jason, you're the man at embracing new feel. I mean, you know what I mean? Like look at your career. You're an entrepreneur. You're bleeding edge. You're embracing new technologies. You're pushing the boundaries of professional communication in the sense of publishing and certainly in your own life from what I've seen in personal communications. And there are a lot of people that are way far behind that curve. And it's like,
I agree with you. You shouldn't be bleeding edge. You shouldn't be the guy like, wow, let me check out Tumblr. Maybe I should help with this. Flip that out. You know, maybe I should F with this for a little bit. You know, I don't want to be screwing around with that. Or, no, this looks like a really cool Facebook application. Maybe I should start zombieing people. But of course. But I think...
Should he have a Facebook page?
Absolutely.
My mother has a Facebook.
Whatever the top 10 websites are, top 20 websites, whatever, communication thing, you should have a presence on each. He should have a missive that he does daily or multiple times a day, if it's short, and he should have a person who is the head of social media for the office of the president. What would we call that?
Well, this guy said we're going to have a CTO.
It's a different thing.
This is part of his press aid. This is part of his
press
aid.
Right. Yeah,
more than press, though.
So they should have a social media secretary, just like they have a press secretary. And the social media secretary should take whatever he's working on and put it into these social things so he can communicate with people. Because this is where people are living right now. So the same way, this conversation...
This is where many people are living right now.
Well, this
go
is
back
a lot of people don't spend a lot of time
okay.
in this.
Go back to tweet number -1432 in 1970 when they were debating should presidents be on TV. And the discussion is the same discussion we're having now. Instead of, you know, going
you're saying this
to
is
television,
mainstream media now.
This is mainstream. There's 100 million people going to MySpace every day from the United States.
I don't
40 million Americans going to Facebook. These are the people. These are the young people, the future of our society. That's where they're going to communicate with the president. They're not going to watch them on TV. They're going to watch them on YouTube and Facebook, and that's the eventuality. So the fact that we as old people, everyone on the phone call is over 30, probably some of us are over 40, I'm not saying anybody in particular. If Dvorak was here, we'd have somebody over 50. maybe even 60. And the bottom line is we think old. And we have to get young people in charge into politics because old people are going to be dead soon.
Well, I think
young people are going to inherit this country.
I think none of this is going to displace what you're already going to do. You're still going to have all the press events. You're still going to do the traditional media. This is all adding to it, and I think that the thing is in many states where they went blue instead of red, a lot of it was done by younger Americans who were more technologically astute, and pulling those and making sure that they stay in your fold from a cynical point of view is very, very important, I think, to keep, to be successful.
I guess the real thing is this a political thing, you know, looking forward to the 2012 election, or is this good governance?
Well, I think it can be both. I think if it's state government, it'll be good for 2012 as well.
I just want to say somebody, a member of the Twit Army and the Twit Live at irc.dfl.stream.com has registered Obama's BlackBerry. So, get ready.
If his BlackBerry starts talking. You know, I have to say, we're not going to do all politics this show, but there are a couple more political stories. One is that on Friday, the transition team named, I think, two very good choices. Head of the Federal Communications Commission review team, Ken Werbach, who I think many people have had the organizer, Supernova, former FCC staffer, he's a professor at Wharton, and Susan Crawford is a professor at the University of Michigan Law School, and this is what I love about them. I mean, not only is there no question that they're going to be promoting net neutrality from the FCC, but listen to this. Susan Crawford was very outspoken. She was at a telecom policy conference in Hollywood in March. Ambassador Richard Russell, the White House Associate Director on Science and Technology Policy, was there. She said very bluntly to him, "You're living in a fantasy land. When you say the United States rollout of broadband is going well," she said, quote, "I think it's magical thinking to imagine we're somehow doing fine here. And I just want to make sure we recognize that even the ITU says that between 99 and 2006, the U.S. skipped from 3rd to 20th place in broadband penetration." She says, "We're not doing it all well for reasons that mostly have to do with the fact that we failed to have a U.S. industrial policy pushing forward," this is the thing I'm excited about, "high-speed internet access penetration. There's been completely inadequate competition in this country for high-speed internet access." And finally, she said, "It's a utility. This is like water, electricity, sewage systems, something that each and all American needs to succeed in the modern era." Boy, that's going to terrify AT&T and Comcast.
Yes, and true.
But that, well, that actually, it also telefies a lot of startups who are angling to, become, we probably Jason could address this more, but the whole, that runs on some level so counter to the free market philosophy and the idea that the free market would provide and that there are options. Because, like, the idea is,
everyone has choices. Wait a minute.
The free market has failed.
Look, if you live in the backwoods of Tennessee where there are five people per square mile, there is no one in his right mind is going to, for business reasons, wire you. It has to be a government thing.
It should be a government thing. This is the same thing that happened with the phone companies here in the United States.
What happened with
the rural
electrification?
Bella. Oh, yeah.
Better than that, but it's not. But, it's not a high quality.
I was told in Japan, the hotel room I'm going to has 55 megabits down.
Yeah, everything there has. They have 100 megabits to your house for like $20.
No, I don't know what to do
with it.
Speed is one issue, but look, there are people out there who are on 36K dial-up, and it's more than 20 or 30% of our population. We need to wire. We need everybody to get online at least. I don't think it has to be 55 megabits. But I think everybody should have a megabit per second every home.
How are they going to do that? Because it's an